tell me, so like, you know. Because I've got issues too with my pinkies, but anyway, I'll hear yours first.
The
ring. Oh, that finger. Oh, no, don't do that. No, we're live here.
Just get in the way. What I'm using is this one. Follows this one.
That's right. That's it's called sympathetic tension. I'll give you a book, Jamie Andres. Not how to practice content, but how the body works when it practices. I'll put it in a flash hour and give it to you tomorrow. When we're playing, like this one, I've always had my fingers on the strings and I feel quite more relaxed than I used to be. I'm not pushing that hard anymore. Like, I kind of
don't. Like,
just use your mind. Your fingers are your mind. You know, your fingers are connected to your mind. You don't have that problem like I used to do. I used to just practice and I used to do wrong all the time, like for hours a day. You know, your approach is more song type and then the shredding type behind the song, so you don't have it heavily ingrained. Mm-hmm. You can get rid of that mistake quickly. You can.
Yes.
The way you learn is you're doing it like a song type thing, and that's how it gets into your system, man.
Mm-hmm.
You can. You're doing recording and all that. That's the way your muscles kind of learn how to do it. Bro, this one here, this is tense. It's not actually this finger. It's a result of other fingers. So when you're practicing, you've got to, your mind has to be with you. It's the hardest thing to do. Jamie Andrews talks about it. Hardest thing to do to realize how much tension is there. And tension builds up here. So your speed is cut off from up here. And it's from the base of the neck. When you're thinking those thoughts of how I'm gonna get the next note, it actually filters down here to your shoulder. So really your fingers, when you play guitar, your whole body plays the guitar, not just your fingers.
Okay.
Your whole body, bro. It was like a revelation to me, bro. Because, you know, we're sitting down, we're so tense all the time, huh? We don't realize why that note's not coming out.
That's worse when you're in front
of people.
Thousands
of
people.
Thousands of people.
Yeah.
You know.
How do you overcome that?
You know.
The things that we do, like practicing or jamming, comes naturally, but then when you're on
stage. On stage.
It's different.
Well, there's two reasons for that. First of all, it's not really in you. You got to forget it. I mean, I'm sure you've heard a musician say, forget to remember. Sometimes don't practice that. You practice it, but you're gonna use it. Don't think about it, practice some other thing. For a month or 2 months before. You know that aphasia that I was doing it, you're like,
I haven't touched it for years. Last time you played on was like in 2001.
Bro, I haven't touched it for years, man. You know, and the last time I played was my pinky finger, and the pinky finger was bugging up, and I just left it. You know, so I was focused on my pinky, you know. But just the thing, if you fix up this one, everything else becomes natural. Because this is usually the root of all the other problems. You don't need to relearn everything. Everyone goes, oh shit, I gotta learn everything again.
See, what I think, this one tends to stick up all the time.
Yeah, and that's tension.
What a more relaxing. Always wants to
come out now.
Yeah.
That's because it's coming out from all the way here. What you're doing is but you don't realize it. The hard, bro, I tell you, you always remember this. The hardest thing is to be aware of how tense you are. That's why. Have you heard of no pausing practice?
No.
Okay, this is what you do. You sit down and you.
Is the tape running?
Yeah, it's the time. It's good.
Hey!
So, bro, what you do is, you know, in the middle of a lick when you're practicing, you stop. So, I like this. I stop. The problem is. And sometimes you'll feel like your finger shaking.
Yeah, it does.
You know, because that's where the tension is. You stop right there and you consciously just sit down and just relax. Get your mind from your head to your shoulder to your neck to the side here and just feel where all the tension is. Because where the tension is, it trickles down to your finger. You clear? So then you sit there. Usually this one here, all everything in here depends on everything that's up here. You clear? And everything up here depends on your neck muscles. So you've really got, you know, sometimes I'll get up during practice and I'll just rub my shoulder and I'll just go like this. And when I think to you, you tense it up, you go, you really, you know, just really tense it up so you know how it feels when it's tense. So you push the muscle, and then you relax it again.